it's about.
Hey, you, what do you think you're doing?
You left a crate of milk bottles in the middle of the footpath. I could have broken my neck.
Then if you've got a complaint, come into the shop. There's no need to wreck the place.
It's people like you that need to be taught a lesson.
Look, lady, I don't know who you are, but you're the one that needs a lesson. I'm going to call the cops.
Oh, fine. You do that.
I will. Don't you worry.
Thanks.
Aren't you supposed to be in Sydney trying to find Patricia?
She's on her way back. Please call me at Fiona's.
Oh, where did they find her?
Well, they didn't. She found them. She was hiding up at Wombye and a couple of Rogers blokes caught up with her. She thought her best bet was to phone the cops for a bit of protection.
Oh, I see.
And the police are flying her straight back to the hospital. Have the knee operation tomorrow morning.
What's that bad?
Yeah, apparently.
Well, it's all happening, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, have you eaten? I can easily fix you something.
Oh, it's fine, thanks. I had some on the plane. More or less just called in to let you know how things were going before I headed off to the hospital.
Yeah, right.
Police are going to keep an eye on her around the clock, but just like to be there to make sure she settles in okay.
Yeah, of course. I was expecting to see you in Sydney, actually. I'm flying up myself tomorrow.
Yeah?
Yeah, well, I finished everything I had to do.
Tell you what. Can't tell you how relieved I was to hear that you were safe. Been worried sick the last couple of days. Anyway, this time tomorrow, she'll be over a lot of her troubles. I spoke to Ross. He's going to do the op. Fix that knee once and for all.
Yeah.
Anyway, hoping to get going. Pat will be at the hospital pretty soon.
Oh, well, you're not going to stay there all night, though, are you?
No.
Well, then why don't you drop back for coffee on your way home? It'll probably do you good.
Sure. Well, I will if Pat's okay. I'll see you.
Yeah.
I think we should have put you in a wheelchair.
It might have been easier.
Pat! Excuse me, sir.
Oh, hang on.
No, it's all right. He's my husband.
You know, I was starting to think that I was never going to see you again.
I'm sorry, darling. I wanted to let you know where... What's he doing here?
Hello, Patricia.
Get him away from me.
Look, Pat, come on.
Dr. Newman's your surgeon.
Like hell he is. I don't want him anywhere near me.
It's all right, Mrs. Palmer. No one's going to hurt you.
No, of course they aren't. Nurse, why don't you settle Mrs. Palmer in,
eh? Oh, I think so.
You're going to stay with me,
yeah,
aren't you?
Of course I am. I'll be with you in a few minutes. Come, I'm sorry about that.
Oh, don't be.
No, I thought she was going to be a bit more stable, you know. Charlie gave me the impression she was.
Let's just get that knee fixed, shall we?
Yeah, sure.
I'd like a cup of tea, if that's possible.
Sorry, no food or liquids until after your operation.
Come in.
And how's the patient?
Oh, resting comfortably.
I'll be back in a few minutes. Don't stay too long, Mr. Palmer.
No.
Has Ross gone?
Oh, Pat.
David, I am serious. I don't want him to do the operation.
The bloke has gone out of his way to try to help you. Now, why are you suddenly having arms against him for?
Because he's trying to kill me.
Oh, come on.
He is. He's working for Roger Carlyle.
How do you know that? Charlie told me that you were getting yourself together a bit, but carrying on like this...
All right. I understand how this must seem to you, but you can see that the man upsets me. Isn't that enough to make sure he stays away? I don't want him to do the operation. Arrange for somebody else to do it. Please, David. For God's sake, is that too much to ask?
Okay. We'll get someone else.
Promise?
I promise.
Thank you.
Roger? It's Ross. We've run into a problem.
We?
Oh, right. I have. Patricia's managed to talk David into insisting somebody else does the operation.
So what are you going to do about it?
Well, we've still got the anaesthetist on side, but I've had to organise a Dr. Ritter to perform the actual surgery.
We'll have to make sure the good doctor is late for his appointment, won't we?
Can you organise that?
I think so.
Roger, if there's any other way...
Can you think of one?
It's just that Patricia's made some pretty vicious accusations. Now, if she dies on the operating table, it's gonna look mighty suspicious.
Well, that's your problem. It's either her life or yours. Just do what you have to.
Yes, all right, David. I'll let her know. Bye.
Let me know what?
Oh, I thought you were still in the bathroom.
He is still coming, isn't he? I mean, don't tell me I've gone and tarted myself up for nothing.
Yes, he's still coming. He's just going to be a bit delayed, that's all. He wants to spend a little more time with Patricia.
So, what's new? I've never seen anyone so devoted.
Yeah, and Anoop certainly doesn't deserve it. But from what David said, she still seems pretty mentally unstable. I mean, the latest is that Ross is working for Roger Carlyle and that he wants to kill her.
How?
On the operating table, and after all the man's done for that woman. He's been so good to her.
Maybe too good.
What's that supposed to mean?
Maybe there's something in what Patricia's saying.
Oh, for God's sake, you're as bad as she is. You're talking rubbish.
No, not necessarily. At first, Patricia didn't want to have the operation, remember? Which was her right. But if she's deemed mentally incompetent, she'd have no say in the matter.
So?
So, it's one way of getting her onto the operating table. And a good surgeon anaesthetist team could do a very neat job without arousing too much suspicion.
How on earth can you talk such rubbish? Ross would never do anything like that, not in a million years.
Barbara, I know you like Ross. I also happen to know the man has gambling debts, and people can be bought.
There's no reason for anyone to buy Ross, because in a few days he won't have any gambling debts. I'm lending him the money to pay them all off. So I'd appreciate it if you kept your crazy theories to yourself before you do the poor man any more harm.
And where are you two off to?
Nightclub.
Bit late, isn't it?
Well, the show doesn't start until 11.
I don't know why you're drowning yourself in booze just because Wayne doesn't want to know you. He's not worth it. Go out and find someone decent.
Alan?
Well, she should. Well, forget him.
Well, if you'd ever been in love, you might understand.
Thank you, Jill.
Well, come on, we want to make sure we get a table.
Wayne, it's Karen.
I've got nothing to say to you.
Wayne, please don't hang up.
Why shouldn't I?
Because you don't understand. I only told Gordon about Patricia being your backer because I was hurt.
My heart bleeds.
I know it was a dreadful thing to do, but you've got to give me the chance to make it up to you.
What do I have to do to get it through your thick skull? It's over, Karen. Finished.
But I need you. I love you. I can make you happy.
The only way you'll make me happy is if I see the back of you. I'll be over tomorrow to pick up my papers. After that, you can drop dead for all I care.
Wayne? Wayne, for God's sake. Please.
It's been a wonderful evening, Fiona.
Yes, it has.
I'll call round and see you tomorrow.
Not too early, I hope.
No, not too early. You'll give me your answer when I do come round, won't you?
Yes, I will.
Good night, Fiona.
Good night, Barney.
How'd you talk your way out of the bullet wound?
Convinced the doc I grazed myself in a hunting accident.
More fool the doc.
I'll get nicked.
Where are you going?
Where the cops or you or anyone else won't find me.
The police aren't looking for you. Amanda wouldn't press charges as much as I try to convince her that she should. You're no good, Mitch. You ought to be locked up where you can't hurt anyone.
Oh, well, aren't you the hypocrite? I read your books on Vietnam, what you and your mates got up to. You gonna let your new girlfriend have a read of them? No, I bet you aren't. But don't worry, I won't say anything. Now that I know what you're really like, I wouldn't want to be around to even spit on you.
Everything's set for tomorrow?
Yeah, finally.
Ross isn't too upset he's not doing the operation, is he?
No, he's pretty good about it, actually. He said that's what Pat wants. It was fine by him.
Oh, I see. Puts paid to one particular theory, doesn't it? Excuse me, David, I'm rather tired. I think I'll go up. See you later.
Yeah, good night. Everything all right between you two?
Oh, yes, it's just a misunderstanding, that's all. You know, I'm sorry to be going back to Sydney in a way. I've enjoyed my stay down here, spending time at your place. It's nice out there, I like it.
Yeah, so did I.
Hey?
Well, I might have to sell it now.
Whatever for?
We'll get some money together. I want Pat to have the best lawyer she can get. I reckon that bloke she's got now is not that crash hot.
Well, isn't there some other way? That little farm's what you've always wanted. You can't sell it.
Oh, yes, I can. It means keeping Pat out of jail for something she didn't do.
Oh, for God's sake. Oh, when are you going to stop throwing your life away on that woman? She's not worth it. What you need is someone more down to earth, like you. Someone who will enjoy the farm and pitch in and make it a real home. Trouble is you're too damn blind to see what's right under your nose.
Oh, what's right under my nose?
That little outburst, I suppose there's no point in pretending anymore, is there? Patricia was right when she said I loved you. It's true. I've loved you almost from the moment I first met you. So, what do you think about that?
Geez, Irene. Talk about the last thing I expected you to say.
Oh, well, maybe I shouldn't have, but that. It's done now.
I had no idea. I never knew.
It's all right, I believe you.
The way I feel about Pat, well, I could never...
Sure, I've realised. I know that... I just wish I'd kept my big mouth shut.
No reason we still can't be mates.
No, of course not. It'll have to be from a distance, though. I'm going overseas.
Yeah?
Yeah, believe it or not, I'm... thinking of going back to medicine. Searching all those places, you know, to spend Amanda's money, sort of got the old juices going again, you know?
It's easy to understand.
Yeah. Mm. Yeah, probably something in research. I think it'd suit me best. You don't have to put on any airs and graces in the lab.
No.
Anyway, so that's why I'm going overseas, you know, to catch up on everything that's been happening while I've been out of action.
You're a terrific person, Irene. You look after yourself, eh?
Yeah, I will.
Cops have got a description of me for our little robbery. If I'm caught and put in a lineup, I'm history. I need money to disappear.
You're not getting any from me. As far as I'm concerned, you can go to hell.
Bitch! If I go under, so do you. No one plays me for a sucker anymore, so just pay up or else.
Only black coffee? No bacon and eggs?
I didn't hear you and Jill come in last night.
Oh, we snuck in about three. Jill's still in bed. All that dancing we did must have worn her out. Oh, something must have.
Aren't we the stud?
Oh, plenty of women who think so. And by the time I get back from Melbourne, I reckon Katie's going to be one of them. You expecting someone?
Oh, no, I just have to beat the bank when it opens, that's all. I don't think you'll get very far with Katie. From what I understand, the girl's a professional virgin.
Oh, don't you believe it. Right wine, right music. I reckon I can change all that.
Morning.
Yes, well, I'm just off to the bank. The coffee's still hot.
You didn't say anything about seeing Katie when you went to Melbourne.
Oh, didn't I?
But you are going to see her.
I sure am. Jill, nobody owns me. So if that's what you're thinking, you're making a big mistake. Don't expect me to offer you something I can't give.
I didn't say I was expecting anything, did I?
As long as you understand.
Sure, fine by me. What's that for?
Well, just to make you relax before we take you in. You'll start to feel a bit groggy soon.
Dr. Ritter is still doing the operation, isn't he?
Certainly is.
That's right, isn't it, darling?
Yeah. Scouts on her.
Sleepy.
Well, not much longer to go now.
Can I see you for a moment, Mr. Palmer?
Yeah, sure. Probably wants to know if you're covered by health insurance. What are you doing here?
There's been a problem.
We've had a call. Dr. Ritter's been in a car accident and he's too shaky to go ahead and operate.
Now, we could cancel it, David, but everything's set to go. Patricia's had her pre-op, and as I was originally scheduled to do the operation, we wondered if you had any objection with me continuing.
Well, I don't know. You know the way she thinks, sir.
Well, that's why we need your permission, though she'd never know anything about it until it was over.
That's not the point. I mean, what happens if she recognises you in the operating theatre?
Oh, it's hardly likely. I mean, Dr. Newman will be wearing a mask and Mrs. Palmer will be very groggy. Look, I'm aware of your wife's attitude, Mr. Palmer, but I don't think we can let that stop her from going ahead and having a badly needed operation.
David, it is in your wife's best interest.
Yeah, okay.
Right, I'll scrub. Sister?
Clear on the procedure?
You just take care of your part, I'll take care of mine.
Okay.
There's got to be no reason for suspicion. The woman's already been telling people I'm out to get her.
Look, I know how to do my job. Just make sure my money comes through.
You on your own?
Yes, it's all right. I made sure everyone was out.
What about the money?
I've organized that too. As much as I could, anyway.
We agreed on 1,000.
300 was all I could raise.
It's not enough. You said you'd give me...
I said I'd do what I could. Alan's the one with the money. You know that. What about your friends? Can't they help you?
Oh, what friends? Thanks to you dragging me into knocking off the Brandon place, I've lost my best mate and found out the bloke I've looked up to for half my life is nothing but a mass murderer.
Not too early, am I?
Yeah, of course not. Come on in.
Thanks. I brought you a little present.
Oh, Barney. Oh, they're beautiful.
Yeah, well, I reckon flowers always brighten up the place a bit.
Yes, they do. I'll put them in some water.
Did you have a chance to think over what I said last night?
Yes. And the answer is,
I love you.
I love you too.
don't have to count it. I said 300 and that's what's there. And don't think you can blackmail any more out of me either.
Get the rest of my papers sorted out?
They're on the table.
Good.
Don't you know how to knock?
Not when I've got a key. But here, have it back. I won't be needing it anymore.
Well, look who it is. Our big hero. Thrown any more people at Knife Point lately, have you?
Oh, get lost.
Hardly surprising, though, is it? Threatening people. That's the only way you could get people interested in you.
You'd know, wouldn't you?
Yeah, well, from now on, you stay away from Amanda. She's not interested.
Well, she's a damn sight more interested in me than she is in you.
Oh, so that's why you dragged her away. You should be locked up, mate. Long Bay is about the only place you're fit for. Oh,
just shut up. Oh,
come on. Oh, come on, get up.
God. You haven't knocked him out.
It's what he deserves.
Mitch. Come on, Mitch. He must have cracked his head. Good God. There's no pulse. He's dead.
What's your name?
Patricia Palmer.
And what are you here for?
Knee operation.
Which knee?
Right knee.
Right. Good. All right, you're just going to feel a small prick in the back of your hand. There we go.
Feels cold.
Didn't expect to see you here this morning, Dr. Newman. Just as well you were here to take over.
Oh. No, please.
It's all right, Patricia. It'll all be over soon.
And dogs.